Hi! Today I will show you how to airbrush popperheads. It's quite fun and it's quite easy and you can start it fairly cheap.
Hi! Today I will paint a fire tiger popperhead, a surface reducer from Flyman company. It's crazy hot out here, so I'll be sweating a lot, but we are going to paint it with an airbrush and some paint. Yes, I'm using these. This is actually a Lexan paint. These are used for painting RC cars, model cars. And I found that this is the best paint for this due to the smooth surface on these poppers. So this works fine. I'm only using a few drops. I'll start by applying a thin layer just to get a coat on the top. It's very important that you don't overdo the painting, because then it will just be a mess to look at. So a thin layer and let it dry. Now that we are out in the sunshine, it won't take long for it to dry up. Yes, I've put in some yellow mixed with the green to make a smooth transition between the two colors. And I'll just paint the sides and the inside where the eye is placed. That's the yellow. And you can see the transition between the two colors.
Yeah, very, very smooth.
When you're painting, it's a good idea to have
A blow dryer.
Blow dryer,
I think it's called.
Yeah, it will help you to dry up the paint even faster, and then you will be able to paint on without ruining the paint you have done.
Nice.
Yeah. With these foam heads, it's important that you don't overdo the blowing, because it's hot air, and the foam will melt down. I've learned that the hard way, a lot of times. So be gentle with the blower.
Blow gently.
Blow gently. And the last color is the fluorescent orange. Just gently at the bottom.
I see the distance from your airbrush to the popperhead is quite essential, right?
It is, because the further I get away from the popperhead, the more wide the spread will be.
Yeah.
The closer I get, you will see that when I'm making the shells on top of this one.
Okay.
That I would get even closer to get more paint in a small area. But when I'm doing this fine work, I'm fairly close as well. There we are. This is a template I'm using to make the pattern on the back of the frog. These are scale patterns, but you can use everything. I even have here. This is inner pocket from an old vest I'm using to make a pattern. And this one here is from an old bag, also inner pocket with a smaller mesh grid.
Nice.
And you can also buy these fairly expensive templates you can use to make some kind of, I don't know, it looks like a frog pattern, flamey something.
Nice.
So there are a lot of possibilities, it's only your imagination. But on these ones I'm using this template. I put in some moss green color. And here I will place the popperhead directly on the surface, because then I can place the template directly over it like this. You will do it like this, then you can also see it with your camera.
Yeah.
You need to get the template fairly tight around the popperhead, otherwise it won't be a smooth pattern. So, and here I'll also go gently. And when you're painting these small popperheads, less is more. Don't use too much paint, because then it will just be a mess.
Very, very, very nice. You see that? That's awesome. Really, really, really awesome. That's how it's done. Nice, nice, nice work.
See, we have some over here. The green has not been completely dry, the fluorescent green, but I can cover that up because the darker color will not take the fluorescent green paint. So I can just give it a light brush and then these small dots here will be gone.
Ah, nice.